Now, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. has appointed a new head of the Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency. Retired Police General Moro Virgilio Lazo will be taking over as Director General of PIDEA, replacing Wilkins Villanueva. Lazo is a former Special Action Force commander who was also once a part of the now-defunct Philippine Constabulary and the Presidential Security Group during the Ramos administration. His appointment comes more than a week after the eldest son of Justice Secretary Crispin Remulla was arrested in an illegal drugs operation by the agency. President Marcos stands by his decision to remain as agriculture chief. Speaking to reporters, Marcos said it will take a president to reorganize and solve deeply embedded issues in the department. He insists there are things that only a president can do that a department secretary cannot. At the 48th Philippine Business Conference and Exposition, which Marcos attended, he was given 10 resolutions, which included recommendations related to ensuring food security.
I am much gratified that when I heard the enumeration of those 10 resolutions, that they are very much in line with the government's thrust and the government's directions that we feel will be the most advantageous for the Philippines. And in that regard, I assure you that the concerned agencies will assess the feasibility and probability of success of these recommendations.
In other news, the Commission on Elections admits it can no longer hold the polls in December should the Supreme Court rule in favor of a petition questioning the postponement of village elections. Attorney Romulo Macalintal filed the petition before the Supreme Court, arguing Congress has no power to move the elections or extend the term of village officials. COMELEC Chairman George Garcia says they have already slowed down their preparations.
As far as the COMELEC is concerned, we prepared fully, but as of October 10, 2022, we slowed down the preparation because of the law assigned by the President, Your Honor. And so if we will be asked the question, if we are ready to hold the election by December, probably will say that there is no material time on the part of the Commission to proceed with the election by December 5. And so we will proceed with the procurement later. We will proceed with the printing of the ballots later and such other activities, Your Honor, in relation to October 2023 elections.
The Village and Youth Council polls were scheduled on December 5, 2022, but President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. approved the postponement, resetting the schedule of the polls to the last Monday of October 2023. President Marcos wants Filipinos to stop treating the COVID-19 pandemic as an emergency. The chief executive says the country should already start going back to normal to spur economic growth.
We have to get away from the emergency stance of the DOH, because we have to open up businesses. We have to make the Philippines more hospitable to travelers, both business and tourists. We must treat COVID no longer as an emergency, but something that we will have to manage forever. It's like flu, like pneumonia.
But Marcos says he will not lift the nationwide state of calamity yet, as the government still has to resolve several non-health issues.
Pag tinanggal ko yung state of calamity, hindi makukuha ng ating mga health.
They got the spike protein.
Now, the Philippine government, urged by a health expert, to already secure bivalent vaccines to combat new COVID variants. Infectious diseases specialist Dr. Ronjin Sanante says these can be administered as a third booster dose for vulnerable populations. His plea comes amid the rise of more vaccine-resistant COVID subvariants like the XBB strain, which has already entered the country.
That is why it's bivalent, because you have the spike protein of the original Wuhan and the spike protein of the subvariant of your Omicron, targeting B1, B4, and B5. Comparing it with the monovalent, the neutralizing antibody was superbly higher. And they tested the antibody against the Omicron, B4, the B5, and also the BA.1, and higher protection, maintaining its protection also against the alpha, the beta.
Solanda himself has received a Moderna bivalent dose in the U.S.